Hello, one and all. This is Luckless Lovelocks. Welcome back to Obduction. Although we didn't really have any text to read in Captar, we learned quite a bit. If you're paying attention to what we've read previously, we saw examples of all the things that were mentioned in the stuff in Farley's capsule. We saw that someone carved dwellings for the Arai, right? We could see like whole areas carved out. Whether or not those like city areas were meant to be for the Arai, I'm not really sure. That might have been, it said an ancient species formed a bond with them. That could have been their home, right? And then they carved out other tunnels for their barnacles or eggs, which I think that's what we're seeing here in what I assume is Farley's house. We also saw these massive creatures. It looked like sea creatures. And there was mention of a more recent species that took over that was very adept at mechanical construction. And we obviously saw all those mechanical, those huge machines everywhere in Captar. That must be evidence of them. And they were using the beetles as bait for large flying creatures. I don't know if that's what those creatures were or not, but it could be. They looked more like I said, underwater creatures, or maybe like I saw some legs, so maybe they're just huge land creatures. I'm not sure. So even though there isn't stuff to read, there's still a lot of environmental storytelling in this game, and this is looking like Farley's house, who is very very close at the Arai. So let's see what we find here. I'm pretty excited. Got paintings of Captar. That's pretty cool. Part of Captar came home with her. What's that? Oh, his arm fell off. I see. Alien on the side there. Does this work? Nah, it doesn't look like it. Oh, there's like a number here. Can't really tell what it says. Something 45. 3145? I wonder if that's gonna be important. Probably not, eh? These could be backer items. Cool. Some of the machinery, or like a cast of the machinery. Phases of the moon, maybe. I don't know if that's gonna be important. In a bedroom, okay. Must be Farley's bedroom. Samurai chipmunk. Yeah. CF. Huh. These are barnacles. It's kind of strange that she just had them here. Weird. And a book. Okay. Now we're going to get some answers. 5997 AH. The Valain. I can't find the words. It's such a foreign life cycle. Perhaps not. They launched themselves across the expanses of space, preserved for eons until at last their technological arcs can hone in and carry them to a new home. They have no connection with their predecessors, but in spite of this, perhaps because of this, they have amazing recollections of their history. Their stories are epic, reaching back through the eons. Unlike many of us who were abducted, they were abducted as a whole. Their scoop moved an entire facility that was about to be annihilated. Oh, interesting. So kind of like it seems like the people that were abducted were avoiding catastrophe. Also, these whole kind of groups of them were avoiding catastrophe. I come to believe that they, perhaps more than any of us, have a deeper understanding of whatever this strange system is that we find ourselves in. 16333. That's quite a bit later. That's like a year later or something. I need to write this down. We buried Xion today. This place never really agreed with her. Kept to herself mostly. Depressed and downcast. Anyway, I digress. I stayed after the brief words were spoken. I was the last to leave. I wandered to the dome, as I often do, and looked out at the undulating Saurian weirdness beyond the cell wall. So that's the home of the Mofang that we're seeing, Soria. Movement caught my eye. Now, on very rare occasions, we've seen Mofang scrambling about in the distance. But there have been fewer and fewer sightings over the years. But before me was a tall, haggard Mofang, running desperately, almost directly toward me, from one of the distant structures. It, I still can't tell the gender, got closer and closer. I thought it would see me and stop, or turn around, or be curious about this strange dome and our world inside it. But it continued running, quickly, almost directly to my position. I was frozen in place with curiosity, till my reflexes took over at the last moment, and I leapt out of the way. But rather than hit the dome and fall backward, or come through into Hunrath, the dome flashed its familiar tone, and the Mofang vanished. I was stunned for a bit, but I retrieved my wits and stepped into the dome myself to quickly get to the other side. After getting through, I immediately turned around and saw the Mofang outside, on the other side of the dome, still running away from whatever it feared, but as if it had no sense of passing around the dome. As surprising as the event was, it did serve to settle a few things in my mind. I always wondered how no one on Earth noticed what had replaced this chunk of Arizona we have here. Yeah, I was talking about that before when we first found out that there was, that, like, this is a little bit like swap parts of worlds, but I guess it's almost, maybe it's like a pocket dimension or something. It's not perceivable on the other side. 16772. That's another, like, more than a year. I've got event. Again, there are those who argue with me. Over and over, I demonstrate that in almost every case, whatever the process was that brought us here, it occurred at a pivotal moment. They tell their stories, and they still can't admit that the abduction actually saved each of us. All of us. What is it in human nature that grasps so strongly to the past that we blame our saviors for stealing it from us? Okay, just one more vent before bed. If each of us was individually saved from something, then maybe all of us were corporately saved from something larger. Can we really be sure what's left? And this, the arrivers come from various places and times. Sarah got here almost 15 years ago from the year 2055. And Uziel got here 2.5 years ago from 1942. What does that mean? Time here is shuffled and chaotic compared to Earth. What state is Earth in right now? When is Earth right now? It's almost like you can't... Once again, it's like this place is out of time. You can't think of it in that way. You have to think of it in a different way. What that way is, I'm not really sure. 16,787 AH. That's not too long after this last entry. Like 15 days? It's 3:15 a.m. and I feel compelled to journal this craziness. After spending most of yesterday meditating with the Arai, and then most of this evening discussing the nature of these worlds with CW, I had just a sip of infamous Hunrath hooch and collapsed in my chair. Well, I just awoke from a dream. I'm not one who puts a lot of credibility in dreams, but maybe the Arai were able to move something in me to understand, or possibly because of the intense discussion, my subconscious mind was triggered to be able to sort out some logical connections. Or maybe it was the hooch. The dream. I was tending a garden. An immense garden. And it wasn't for food or flowers. It was just about the health of the garden. I kept working and working to control it and contain it and make it healthier. But the garden seemed to fight me at every turn. And after what seemed like days of work, I finally gave up in frustration. And as I stood there, doing nothing, the garden flourished before my eyes, growing and spreading in every direction. Because, I realized, the system that the plants were based on was not about me shaping and controlling. The natural system of plants is healthier when they are out of control, when they are free to spread and intermingle and cross-pollinate and mutate. Now, from a human point of view, that may not provide what I want. I get smaller fruit and smaller flowers and untidiness. From the point of view of the plants, they grow stronger and much more resilient and resistant. The more they are scattered, the higher their odds of surviving. Now that I contemplate, I realize that even the individual plants and seeds may not appreciate the benefits of what's happening. They are torn far from their origins, forced into situations that seem extreme, possibly even destroyed by these new environments. But for the seeds that survive, the seeds that survive. Now that's where real growth, strength, and abundance comes from. So beautiful and terrifying. Beyond the beauty of it all is a system and structure that defies understanding. Okay, what if this is all a natural process? There are signs of something behind it all. But well-hidden signs. So, well, if I look at all of this, the cell, the tree, the water, the seeds, the hub, the health, even the abductions, well, there seems to be a grand system or plan. The plan doesn't take me into account. It is unemotionally intent on the health of something much bigger. That may hurt my feelings, but, well, what am I in the entire scheme of the universe? I have no idea what, if anything, might have put this process into motion, but that is irrelevant. Tomorrow I will talk with CW. He could be swayed from his battery plan. That's highlighted. So CW is still intent on using his battery for some master plan. 17.145. Wow, that was a long entry. 145, that's like another year after this. I really don't journal much. I came to write this down because I am distraught. As I contemplate the plan that I have set in motion, I realize that I have become the destroyer of worlds. I sat down to write, to seek some cathartic tranquilization. And I realized the last thing I journaled was some esoterically beautiful philosophy about letting this garden grow. Not so reaffirming or calming, but nevertheless, here is my reasoning because I must write this down. Simply, it's us or them. Complexly, if this is some kind of garden and we're the plants or seeds or whatever, well, some of us have gotten together and decided that we're the better choice to survive. If the others have unilaterally decided that we all won't survive. I am more fit, damn it. This is not me. I want to be calm and garden or ungarden or grow or... What gives one species the right to destroy another species? Who gets to choose? Do I just lay down and die because the more aggressive species thinks they're better, more powerful? What brutal scale do I use to measure the good of some against the life of others? Does love ever destroy? In order to help more survive? To help love itself survive? Does that even make sense? Can I kill because I think it will bring about more love? What if I'm not even capable of understanding the situation of hate versus love? Maybe I am the hater. Do I generate this love delusion to help me maintain my sanity in light of the choice I have made? My God, it's too much. If these are just my walls of delusion, then I choose to live within them. I am a seed. scattered by the wind. But I will not simply be trampled. I will kick and scream and survive. May God have mercy on my soul. Some intense thoughts. I've got to check everything out. Who knows? JM. Can't remember Yosef's last name. Can I grab this? Flowers are wilted. What is this thing? It's all for puppet shows, I guess. You hear that? It sounds like something's trying to communicate. Oh, there's some pink ones here. Okay. Array Larval Notes by Catherine Farley. Takes about 3 to 5 days for a single array larvae to change colors after being moved to a new surface. It's a surface that determines the color. Pulsing stops immediately upon removal from Captar, induced by polyarchs. Okay, so I was right. These are the barnacles. Cloning has been extremely easy, like potatoes easy. Organics, plant fiber, yellow, bone, light yellow. These are things that I guess they put the barnacles on. Array encrustment, green. Metals, gold, pink, copper, red, orange. Huh. Titanium, orange. Silver, red. Aluminum, red, orange. Oh, and then she even tried putting it on the tech. Mofang tech, magenta. Belain extrusions, near white. This might be important then, because it might identify certain things on Captar that we've missed, just based on the color of the barnacles. So granite on Captar, teal blue. Sandstone, Hunrath, light blue. Swordstone, Mofang, deep purple. Swordstone must be the stone that's holding up those things that are flying. Purple, shale, moray, very light blue. Or maybe that's supposed to be soapstone, I don't know. Polyarch pods, always purple. Huh. To do. I'm curious about the effect of combining various base surface. Still a bit odd experimenting with the life forms. The light they emit is handy, given our limited supply of diesel fuel. Absolutely. Absolutely. Is there anything on the other side of this? I want to take a picture. So here she is. There's one on gold. Okay. Oh, we get some paintings of some of the people. This is the Ark of the Covenant. that's where it ended up. It totally makes sense. More books, looks like. Wait, are these... Oh, these aren't openable. Cerberus. Adventures in the Ages of Mist and Beyond, of course. Cool. And Mist. Oh! Hello! What is that? Is this like everything you need to be able to play Mist? What the fuck? I don't know if this has any kind of like implications for puzzles, but I can't actually grab anything. Weird. So I think this is going to be important. Which colors are really interesting to me? Knowing that, I don't know, the polyarch pods, so purple. Mofang, tech, magenta, I don't know. If I see some strange colors, I'll just consult this. Is that it? Is that all there is here? Not that I'm complaining, I'm just wondering if there's like any kind of hints for puzzles that I'm missing. We could talk, maybe try talking to CW about the battery plan before we go back. He can finally clue us in on what he's got going on. Not the fastest way to get there. We could also go back. I'm not sure if I want to go back the way that I came from, because I might want to see what was transported back there. See what's going on with CW. It's probably just going to tell me to connect everything still. Sounds busy.
Pardon me, but you've got trees in other worlds. Roots to connect. Connect that cable on the side of the battery if you make it. Go on now.
You don't want to talk about your plan? I'd like to know exactly what it is. Before I do all this work. Okay, let's go back. Go back this way. Can. But want to go back this way. Let's just go back and we'll try the other one and then decide. I want to see what's changed. I'm going to go back this way. Oops. I want to see what's changed with that land being brought back to Kaptar. Might reveal something. Take as long as it normally does. Okay, this way. Still haven't really had any indication of how to solve that crazy machine puzzle. Okay, so these ones are yellow. And that's because let me check that out again. Or like orange, yellow, copper. Copper or titanium. Makes sense that this would be copper. Although, copper oxidizes, which means exposed to oxygen, it turns green. Kind of like this, but it turns very, like, a very... Starts out, it's a very bright green as it's exposed to the atmosphere. The reason why I know that is because I'm from Canada and the Parliament buildings, the roof of the Parliament buildings is covered with copper, and they replaced the roofs fairly recently, and it was this nice, beautiful, like, bright copper color, and then over time it gradually turned green. So this has got to be... So it's green. Awry encrustment. Huh. This is an encrustment. I was just assuming this is from another place. It does not look like it belongs here. Looking for purple. Oh, right, okay. To go through here. So we're looking into another world here. That's got to be the Valaine world, homeworld, right? Those are blue. Teal blue, granite, or sandstone. Hunrath. So that could be granite from Kaptar or sandstone from Hunrath. I bet you that's gonna replace the part that's in Hunrath. That's more of a teal, I think, than that. Okay, so this is the one that I think probably goes to the Valaine homeworld. Right. And where's that other chunk that we just brought back here? Should be just around here. Okay. Nothing special. Try going to assume is the Valaine homeworld, and I'm hoping that'll open that door as well. Oh, did we not go? Yeah. Came from there, I think. Or did we? Did I not go up here before? I did not go up here before. Hello! Whoa. The intensity of the music is rising. Have to go across. Okay, before I do that, actually, hold on. This looks like an entranceway, does it not? That's strange that it just goes nowhere. Let's go through the other seed, see where it takes us before we cross. See a seed over there. Oh, right. Yeah, this definitely looks like the first one we encountered. That took us to that very green world that we're seeing in the background of the dome here. Another laser. Oh, a panel. Okay. I don't know what that does yet, so I'm not gonna play around with it. Oh, there's the door. That must be what we used to open the door. Okay, so should we just... everything? Boom! Door opened. Beautiful. We have a way forward here. Okay, before we do that, go back to Kaptar and go travel across. Although, didn't we come across there previously? Not sure about that. What I'm hoping is it'll take us to the other machine that we initially fixed, and we can get by that that god-awful puzzle. Oops. That would make sense, yeah, because there's the tree. So, to get to the original machinery that we fix. Yeah, and it goes like that, so we're gonna be up there. Yeah, okay, this is a different one. Perfect. Oh, Oh my god, was that thing just a troll? What if you guys did tell me that it said that Russian on the back translated to boondoggle? And that's the only way I could describe this. That was like an elaborate troll. Oh my god. Fuck off. Oh, maybe not. Maybe there's more to it. Wait, this says 01. Is it just mirroring what this one says? It's gone. What? You've got to be kidding me. Someone's messing with us. Someone is here and someone is messing with us. And this is gonna go down. Oh no, 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 no. Okay, it's attached. I get it now. It's attached. I thought someone moved it. It's attached, so when we lowered the stairwell down, it came up. And so it is just... Okay, it's just a troll. Now where is this taking us to? Oh, I know. This is the sphere. It's gotta be on the other side of that door? Cool. I see purple in there. The polyarchs, maybe. This has got to be this sphere in Hunrath. Let's check it out. So we need a stairwell that's going to lead up to over there. So we're going to have to rotate. We're going to have to rotate the sphere and bring it back. So this is the direction it'll have to face in, I believe. This allows us to do anything here, though? Probably not. Okay, this just makes so much more sense. Now, my question is, if we rotate this piece here and then we switch them, there's no way it's rotating it in Kaptar, right? I guess we'll find out on the next episode, guys. Gonna wrap up this one here. We got a really good glimpse into the mind of Farley, questioning her decision to go ahead with the plan. Ones look dead. Okay, guys, this is Luckless Lovelocks signing off for now. We're doing it. I love you all.